Jason's gonna, we gotta go through a little crowd. Let's call the special meeting of the North St. Paul City Council in order for the purpose of candidate interviews for the vacant council. Just for the public purposes, if you haven't seen the agenda, the interviews are Doug Edge, who's will be starting in a second here. At 5:30, we will be interviewing Alan Robbins Fender. Council will be taking a break at 6, just to freshen up, and we start again at 6:30 and interview Bob Zick, and then at 7, Tom Sonic. And following that will be the discussion and appointment of the council and then adjournment. So Jason's going to talk a little bit about...
Just a point, since it is a council meeting, you probably should adopt the agenda. So okay. I should put it on there, but you probably should point of order.
It's been moved by Councilmember Furlong.
Second, Your Honor.
Seconded by Councilmember Alzek. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, the motion carried. Okay. Jason, the floor is yours.
Yeah, so as you kind of referenced, you have four interviews today for the council vacant position. One's at 5:30, then you have a break at 6, and then 6:30 and 7. The break at 6 is council requested. There will be food in the Sandberg room, so an opportunity to get something to eat before you continue on with the discussions. At the conclusion of the last interview at 7 o'clock, estimating all the interviews to be about 25 minutes roughly, I guess you have to make the decision if you want to break or just kind of keep going. So the process really after the interviews will be to discuss and determine ultimately who you want to appoint to the vacant seat. That is why you took the applications. Certainly you're under no obligation to make an appointment this evening if you don't feel that you're ready to do that. But it is a special meeting, so that you have the ability to do that. The person will become a member of the council this evening, not official member of the council until they're actually sworn into office on the 16th. So we will set them up with an iPad that all you have and get that information so that they can start receiving any information, packet materials, also to attend the first budget meeting on the 9th of June. And we also do, myself and maybe some staff will do some onboarding just to get the new candidate caught up with some of the different things that are currently going on in the community right now. So that's really all I had as it relates to that. So,
okay.
The floor's yours.
Good. And before we start, Doug, I just relax. I mean, you know all of us, and I'll be telling all the candidates that. I mean, we're just here to try to find out a little bit more about you and your interest in the council. And we'll be asking, I think, about 10 questions, and we have approximately about a half hour that we'd like to run through those. And we're going to alternate, kind of go around the table and asking the questions. And that's everything. We may have some follow-up of all the candidates will be asked the same questions, except there might be a follow-up or clarification, kind of a follow-up if anybody has those at any time. So we're glad you're here, glad you're interested, and welcome. And Terry, we'll start with the first question.
Doug, why are you interested in elected office, and what drew you to apply?
I'm a military man, was in the U.S. Navy, Pershing Gulf War, worked on the flight deck. I take our country serious, our rights, our freedoms. When I got out of the Navy, I grew up here, actually, well, somewhat. Lived a little bit by the ball fields down at night. I remember going up to the cannon, snowman, the slide. I had great memories of North St. Paul. I basically grew up in the east side of St. Paul, my 3M kind of. Getting out of the Navy, I was looking for a home, and memories of North St. Paul kept coming back. Going to the lake, fishing, all these things. I actually went to preschool at North. Something stuck with me. So, driving around looking for homes, I found this beautiful home and great location. North St. Paul's great location. You're around everything, easy to get to, and I fell in love with it and moved here 20 years ago. I'm very passionate about things and I'm trying to stay with the personal and other issues, but I had some things come up in the last few years and a little frustrated. And when I see the town, things going on, business not coming here, you know, rather than just complaining, I feel like I need to step up. When I ran a couple of years ago, I went and talked to businesses. I actually spent a lot of time talking to them, and one of the biggest questions they asked me is, Doug, we can't vote for you. Why are you here? I go, you know, my thing is, I'm the voice of the people. That's what I'm here for. I don't think they have a voice right now. Businesses, I don't think the workers here have one. I've heard some things going on, you know, in the past. I think things get slightly better, but you know, that's why I have a passion for politics and government and our country.
This is the same they come from for you.
Well, they don't live in town, I think, is what it
is. Well, if they don't live in town, they don't have to say, they don't have to vote.
That's what he meant.
So.
I caught that.
Okay, yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Then Candy will shoot the next question.
What is an area of interest in a local municipal government and why? What is an area of interest?
Just one area?
Municipal government and why?
I guess my biggest area, and I don't know if it would be working with the police, if there's a commission on that or something, but the rights of the people and standing up for those.
Quick answer, that was good.
Well, I think if you look right now in Ferguson, all these things going on, which I don't agree, there's so many issues going on, but I see they're based on something, and I see how those things can explode, and the bottom line is, as government, all that, we need to be fair and make sure we're following the rules and what we're doing, otherwise those things can't happen. And again, I don't agree with what's going on and how it's been handled, but you know, that's where integrity, all these things come into play, and that's what I want to focus on.
Yeah, hopefully Jan's voice is going to last with the next question.
What three challenges do you see facing the city council, other than the budget or financial?
Well, I think you're off to a great start. And again, I'm trying not to be personal in here, but great start of this year. I think things got better with the police, and I think we're on the right path. But you put up a code of conduct, and we have flags here. We have all this symbolism. And I just don't see it. I mean, to be honest with you, when I heard we weren't going to have an election, I was pretty frustrated. As a veteran, you have an ordinance here, and you chose to throw that out. How do you expect the people to abide by it if you don't follow your own ordinance? And the other thing is, elections are sacred. People are dying all over this world for elections. Yet, this council chose to just throw that out. And, you know, some of the issues I've had recently, I've talked to the Attorney General's office, the state, and Secretary of State. And the one thing they keep telling me is, well, take it to the polls, Doug, take it to the polls. But he took the polls away from me. So it's a little frustrating.
I forgot what were your two questions.
I just wanted three challenges.
Oh, and what I'm getting at is, I think the challenge is, with the media nowadays and the Facebook and everything else, people see these things that go on. And when they're looking into whether it's a business, they're in contact with their vendors, and hey, we're thinking of putting a new office in or this or that. Hey, how is it there? Hey, you don't want to come here. That's what they're saying to each other. And I hear this from businesses. They're going to Maple, they're going to Oakdale. We got to change that image, and we were on the right path, okay? And we kind of got off that path. And I think part of that integrity, and nothing personal, Mayor, but I really don't think you should be sitting in on this, considering we're here because, you know, you apologize, and that's great, but, you know, there's a conflict of interest, I believe, here. And this is the kind of thing people see. And when they want to move to a city, they're looking at these things now. People, it's easy to move now, and they're looking to, hey, where are the jobs? Where are these businesses close to the good? We have great schools here. That is one wonderful thing we have. Good schools here, great parks. It's a great place. And again, we changed the logo. We were on the right path. And I think we got off that path. And we got to get out there and tell businesses, hey, we're open. And right now, I think North St. Paul is not a very friendly place to businesses or to residents. And again, you're on the right path of that, but we got off of it. It's time to get back on that path. And I think that is, in debate, challenge, whether it's the mayor or another council member, I think in challenges, you come out with, oh, I didn't think of that. You know, maybe I didn't think of that. You're right. And then you can create better ordinances, better laws, better, you know, and you got to sit down when people have issues and talk to them. And I know from my personal issues, again, that nobody wants to come down and talk to us. And we got to get over that.
I get the next one. Again, other than budget or financial, can you name a few things that you see as goals or areas that the city should focus on?
I again, marketing, getting the word out that, hey, North St. Paul's open for business. It's a great, great location in real estate. And I had my real estate license years ago before I went to Navy. It's location, location, location. And you got to sell it. And I don't know if that's using the new media, Facebook, however you do it, coming up with some of that. I think our roads and all that, even since I'm in that business and work that, I think we do a pretty good job with our roads. I know we get some sidewalks, and those are some smaller issues. The parks are great. You know, I know our police has been one of the issues of, this is a small town. I think the police force, it's a luxury. I think it's a great thing. But to have a full police force, and I know there's been talk of the county, there's been talk of Maplewood, and why it's maybe not a great subject, and that's one thing about government. I think it's easy to go to the ice cream socials, and we're all into that, and I'm sure I'd be racing the mayor to get in line for that one. These are issues, you know, that need to be discussed. What's the best thing for the city? Because I'm sure our police department is very expensive. Would we be better off with Maplewood? I don't know. I don't have those answers, but I think there's something that needs to be talked about and looked at, especially I'm sure that I think the chief's probably retiring soon, next few years. So this is a golden opportunity to start looking into that so you don't disrupt things too much. And I'm not saying to get rid of our police by any means, but I think there's other options you can look at to maybe do a better job and save some money since we are such a small town. And
okay. Thanks. Back to Terry.
Have you read the city's strategic plan? And what is it you take away from it, and how do you think you can help us achieve those strategies and objectives?
I'll be honest with you, I read it a while ago, and I really, you know, my mistake for not reading up on a little more, doing some homework.
Candy.
What is your best attribute or strength that you bring into the position? Please describe a challenge or weakness you foresee for yourself if you were appointed.
I think I'm very honest. Integrity. I think one thing about me is, well, I have personal feelings about something. I can put those aside and do what's best. I can look at it and decide what's best for everyone, and I can, like I said, put that aside. And me, it's just getting the facts. Because some of my personal feelings, once I get the facts, maybe a little bit more, I didn't see a certain issue, I'm like, oh, you know what, maybe I was wrong there. I think I have the ability to admit I'm wrong when I'm shown that I am, but I'll fight like crazy when I know I'm right. And maybe that's one of my downfalls. But I'm very honest and upfront, and always plan to be.
Jen, did you get a chance?
Okay, if someone were to describe to you, to us, your leadership style, how would they describe it?
The cities? That's a big area, I think, of concern right now. And I take this from talking to past employees and employees, not a very open management. I think that's our big problem here.
Okay, another question is, what's your leadership style?
Mine? I did lead some crews in the Navy and that, and I like to get everyone's opinion. I like to be part of that and then make a decision. If I know what's right, I'll do it. One of the things my chief told me when I was in there, and I kind of followed his thing, was I'm going to let you do your thing and find out. But when it doesn't work, then we're going to do it my way. That way you're going to find out what you did right or wrong. But I'm always open to new and better ideas. But at some point, if a decision needs to be made, I can make it. And I'll do that based on trying to get all the facts I can and whoever I need to talk to find them.
Great. Next question. Council members often have to make, you know, tough decisions. I know you've seen us go through some of those that are often disagreeable and emotional to citizens. How will you balance making the right decision knowing you might not make friends in the process?
Well, it's a great question, and again, that goes back to respecting each other and debating, and through debate whether you like it or not, it might be a bad issue, but getting out, everything out in the forefront so everyone knows where we're at. And then part of that is, within that debate, is are we following the law? If we don't know, let's find out. If we got to table something, let's table it. And Jan, I mean to pick on you, but I know, and this has been with all of you, but one particular meeting, I remember you looked very frustrated, and then you said, I don't understand this, whatever, and I thought, that'd be a good point to either table it, but then you guys end up passing, and you voted on something. I'm thinking, if you don't know, nobody expects everyone here to know everything, by no means. And I realize some things are timely, things that need to move on, but that's where the integrity comes in. Sometimes, you know, you got to slow things down and take a look at it, and if it means you got to table something to get more answers, if you're not happy, you don't make that vote.
Over to Terry again.
I'm going to get long ones. Do you understand that commitment is more than preparing for and attending two meetings a month?
Yes, I do.
How do you see this commitment fitting into your home life, and are you also willing to participate in community events throughout the year?
Well, yeah, that's one reason I'm running. I do want to get more involved in the community. We have a lot of great things going on here, the car show, obviously, and other events. We have things up the lake, and I don't know them all, but yeah, I mean, I realize that's part of it. And, you know, one thing I can tell you about living here is the people are wonderful. I have great neighbors. And, you know, the more I get out and meet them, especially campaigning, and I met some people that maybe didn't agree with me, but they listened and we talked and they had some good conversations you know, so yeah, I realize there's a lot to it. And, you know, again, anybody that does public service is a great thing. You're giving up your time and it's a great thing.
Okay, now why should you be appointed to the city council?
Again, I bring honesty, I'm gonna bring debate, I'm gonna question things. I'm gonna make sure the citizens, if they have an issue, that if it means I need to go out to their home or business and look into it, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna take the time and find out and you know, what needs to be done.
Okay. Well, that's one through those pretty quick, but I guess anything else you'd like to add or you can think of, or any questions of us?
No, and you know, whoever gets the position, I wish them well, and I just hope that maybe, whether I'm on or not, that you've learned something from me that of what's going on, and by all means, call me if you want to get deeper into some of the issues I brought up. And I think that's the only way the city's going to move forward, is to start taking some of these things head on and actually dealing with them.
Okay. Good comments. Appreciate your thoughts.
Great.
Appreciate your interest and your time.
And again, yeah. Always open.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Thanks so much.
Yeah. Appreciate it. Yeah.